Alright, so down here, we've got an abandoned span with no access. It's 25 feet from here to there, laser measured. And down there, again, we have no access. Alright, so what I use is a throw bag from the Arbor industry. Pop it open. And inside here, it's a little hard to see, but I've got coiled line and these throw bags. That's a 16 ounce, whatever. This it'll work. So what I do is I toss it across. And the point is, I'm gonna bounce it under here. I'll show over here. The point is I'm trying to flip it so that when it flips, it goes up and over these and then down into the water. That's the goal. So, it takes a little time. Okay, so then it's just a matter of manipulating it. Not a very fast process. There it goes. All right, so there we got it. Now what I do is I let it drop into the water. Okay, I just tie it off real quick. Doesn't have to be perfect. Then I grab my fishing pole. So with this fishing pole, I use a floating lure with three treble hooks. Then all I do is I pitch this under. Walk over here. Well, maybe this is not a floater. It's not a floater. I just dropped the line further into the water. All right, that should get it. Oh, almost. I just grabbed the wrong lure, but this is how we do it. We fish it back, and since it's not a floater, I'm going to just drop it into the water, all the way to the bottom. Doesn't really need to be tied. Then let's pitch it under. Far enough away. Put it there. I already see it on the line. There we go. So, this
all up.
Okay, so there's the ball. Excess. I do rinse these out when I get home with fresh water. I wash my ropes weekly. Okay, so now throw bag. Got both ends of the line here. And I'm just gonna go to the eye. 5 couple. Now there's much more friction because we're going over the top. There we have it. One line all the way across. It's not tensioned or anything right now. But normally what I do is I climb on the top rope and I use this one and I set it at an angle for tension. And that's how I set a line.